Hi, today I'm going to show you one of my C# applications which I have developed for the research scholars who can benefit by using this application. This application intends you to have a proper note and documentation of books and the various research material that you access on, especially Google Books website. Google Books website hosts millions of books, and you can access some pages. In some cases, you also have full books available on this website. The important thing is that whenever we try to take down the notes from the books, we usually must note from which page the particular information has been taken down. And to keep a tab on various resources at once becomes a tedious task. So in order to make this thing fast and efficient, I have developed this C# application, NOTEMAN. This NOTEMAN not only allows you to take down the notes in large number, but it also helps you to organize your notes systematically. So when you write your thesis and dissertation, this whole arranged knowledge becomes handy. You might be wondering, what is the need of doing this? One of the important feature that has come to my notice over the years is that the whole problem of plagiarism is actually partially attributed to the inability to systematically organize and use the reference material. And that inadvertent error of plagiarism creeps into the research scholar, though he may not be really inclined to use that material. So the whole idea of using this NOTEMAN is to allow you to have a systematic reference system of this Google book source, because many scholars depend on accessibility to the knowledge at this portal where they are not able to buy the books. So I would like to demonstrate how it works. See, you are seeing this application. There are several buttons arranged on the left side which you have to go step by step. Going step by step is important because otherwise the application prevents you to proceed further if you are not able to follow the steps. For example, if I am going to press this button, it will give me the error add folder first. So it is obviously clear that I need to proceed with the button from the top to down systematically. Now let's see how it is to be done. First, I will add a folder. In order to do this, I'll just click one. If I already have a folder of the purpose, then I will just choose one, or I will make a new folder and then I will click OK. So since I'm taking down the notes from this chapter, the SAR revolution, I have already have a folder here, and I have selected this and I'm clicking it OK. So you see the name is already there. Now you have to, next button is about making the file in which you have to store the notes. So you have to click the button and automatically the Word file name is being created. It gives you the year, the month, the day and the time at which the file is created. So you don't have to bother much. It is just clicking a note will allow you to create this file. Now you can skip these set of buttons 1, 2, 3, 4. These set of buttons you can skip it because they are for the different set of purpose which is not intended as a part of my demonstration here. But let us come to the next text box. This is the reference. How to locate the reference? So I would like to use the author surname as a part of the reference. If you see, the author surname is this person is Anthony Hyman. So I'm using this author surname as Hyman as a part of my reference. Now I would like to check that from which page I am actually using the information. So this is the page 75. So I will just put the number 75 here. And now these two buttons are important so far as taking the notes from Google Books is concerned. This test lock basically buttons is actually directing you to the folder in which another program known as the Tesseract I have installed. I will give you in detail how it is to be installed, and you have to locate the file, this exe application of Tesseract, and just click open. So it will say that Tesseract location set, means this program now knows where the OCR engine is. OCR means optical character recognition, means if you have to extract the text from the images, then OCR is the application which does the job. So you have to do it only once, you don't have to do every time. But yes, every time when application is used, then for the first time you have to do it, then rest of the time it will automatically use this application. Now what I have to do, I will take and capture an image from this, and I'll show you how it is done. So for this I use the green shot image capture application. It's a very good application, and it allows you to capture the specific region. So I'll just take down, say for example, first para from this book, and I have captured it and I have saved it on the clipboard. Now as I have copied the clipboard, now I'll go to this Noteman and I will just click the button OCR read. It will read the text from this. As you have seen, this is not the text which can be copied, and you see here the text has already been produced here. So the image was captured. You see, Google Books do not allow you to copy and paste the text. These are all image files, so you can only either save them as image captured, or if you want to do this efficiently, you see the author name and the page number is also available, and the text is also being created. Now let me move to the next page. For example, I am moving the page number 76, and here I also find that there is something new information is available for me and I need a note of it. I will again press the button green shot, and I will capture this area of interest for me. And see, this para I am taking down, and I have copied it on the clipboard. Now what I am doing is I will just click this forward arrow button, and my page number automatically increments by one digit. And now I will press the button OCR read. Now you see what is happening. The new page number is already available, and now this note is also being extracted from here. Let me do it one more time to show you. Okay, this is the third one which we will be using for demonstration. The green shot, I am using it for capturing this paragraph, and as you see, now I will copy it on the clipboard. I will increment the page number by one digit, and then OCR read. Now this is being done. So this whole note has been extracted from the Google Book. Now I have to export this note. So these buttons are only used when you have to store the note. So I have exported, and this content is exported to the file, this file number which was created. Now if you want to see the file, then you have to use the open note button, and you can see the notepad is containing your reference properly, and as well as the page numbers. So you can always use this, and you can use the reset button to again start working again, and you can keep on doing it. So this is one of the applications which you can use it for properly taking down the notes from the Google Books portal, which is very helpful for the students. Thank you for watching.